We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we are talking Ping irons. We've just been able to get our hands on the new Ping-i59, so now seems like a great opportunity to be able to show where this fits into the family and show you how all of the Ping irons compare against each other so you can make a more informed buying choice. Let's get started though by telling you more about this new Ping-i59. Ping-i59s, if you're an avid equipment fan, it's highly likely you might well have already seen these out on social media and online as well. The Victor Hovland has already won an event using a set. Just start us off, Neil, just telling us a bit more about them, because they are a replacement for the iBlade, not the i500.
That's where guys will get a little bit carried away, won't they, Simon? It's not a report, like I say, this is more towards the golfer. Replacing iBlade, so probably a better ball strike, but we'll cover that in a sec when we look at a little bit of the technology.
Yeah, I think as well, you know, this is a great example of what has changed over 5 years in the iron market. So the iBlade is 5 years old, the market has moved on massively, so this is now a hollow bodied iron, which just wouldn't have been the case. That sort of construction was barely used in a player's iron just 5 years ago. So what are the updates?
So first thing to pick up on, Simon, obviously, bounce blade length and offset is like an iBlade. So you address, same sort of profile, the sole is a little bit narrower. So you're looking more towards like a blueprint that have got quite a narrow sole, haven't they? Very, very narrow.
Scarily narrow.
Yeah, especially in the long iron. It's beautiful in a short iron, but maybe a bit, it could be difficult in a long iron. Aluminium core there, insert. So it gives it the high MOI. So you're going to get a smaller, this is quite a clever thing, really.
Very clever.
So you're going to get a smaller footprint, a smaller head like an iBlade, that's a little bit smaller than like an i210, but you're going to get the same forgiveness. Mm-hmm. Very, very, very clever there.
And that's what a hollow head can bring to the party, isn't it?
Yep. So now this is the one that's striking me the most. I think we need to pick one. So there's going to be four more grooves on the face of this iron now.
Okay.
So Ping are saying that this is going to reduce some flyers in the short irons and maintain a little bit more spin in the long irons.
Okay.
Maybe before I've even hit any, I might start to see some higher ball flights maybe because of the more grooves. Surely it's going to introduce more spin, Simon, you would like to think. But you've got an interesting point to make, haven't you, about coming in from the rough of these.
So the Callaway, they make two sets of irons. So their tour players can choose between standard grooves or more grooves. And their players really are split 50-50 between the two, you know, so it's down to personal preference. But what typically happens is when you play from the rough with more grooves, that shots come out a little bit slower and spin more. So you either need to hit them harder or else you need to club up, you know. So there's sort of trade-offs and workarounds on both sides.
Got to get that right, really. Don't just think that it's just going to be perfect from the rough because it's got a few more grooves. The next one. So this is actually, so it's a forged body, but steel face. Now, a lot of the other manufacturers are going the other way, aren't they? So they go more of like a cast body with a forged face. So that's going to be quite interesting.
It really feels as well, you know, the Ping's changing because Ping never used to make any forged irons. And now we've seen the answer, we've seen the blueprint.
Yeah.
So this feels like a gradual sort of process, you know, working, really elite golfers into forged models.
And then finally, obviously, the Hydro Pearl finish, which obviously we're seeing the wedges, which basically just gets rid of moisture. So on those, when you're playing in the rain or you're coming out of the rough, hopefully it might give you that little bit more control, spin numbers anyway.
Okay, and one of the things that Ping say with this, you know, is this is a precision iron. So every single head is 100% inspected, which isn't the case with all irons that you buy. And then also, if you're into a retro lofts, a power spec, you can get all of this from this one model. So the power spec is 2 degrees stronger in the 7-iron, a retro spec's 2 degrees weaker. So depending on your personal preference, how you see the game, you can set the i59 up into the exact setup that you want to play.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get out and start testing. the six Ping irons, Neil. So how do people choose which one might suit them?
Yeah, so you can categorise this a little bit, Simon. So let's start with blueprint. Obviously, a muscle back iron, very, very small profile, probably some of the smallest that you're ever going to try on the market. Thin top line, it looks tiny behind the golf ball, but a fantastic looking club. But remember, what you put on the line and using those, and the long irons especially, is the forgiveness ratings. Not much forgiveness in there, just due to the fact of the size of the head. Right, the new i59, which is just really, really fantastic looking golf club. You've got, obviously, probably a bit more forgiveness there over the blueprint, but you're still going to get that workability, small profile. Into your i210, probably one of the most popular irons I've ever made, Simon.
Still the most played ping iron on tour, isn't it?
That speaks volumes, doesn't it, what they're using for the guys. So all round, very, very good iron. Obviously, your player's distance iron.
Yeah.
i500.
So that's been around for a number of years, so it's highly likely that might get updated soon.
So obviously hollow-bodied, that's where the distance is going to come from with the design and construction. Now, G425, as we all know, very, very popular iron. Good-looking, mid-handicap iron, plenty of forgiveness, I'd say a larger head, but not too big where it looks like, is this super game improvement? Like I say, fantastic for your guy that struggles a little bit, miss hits over the face, going to maintain a little bit more ball speed. Quite easy to launch in the air.
It just suits a wide audience.
Yeah, there's quite a few that guys are going to fall into that. And then if you're a beginner golfer, high handicapper, looking for maximum ball speed, really, maximum forgiveness, then the G710 would be a good option. It also looks a little bit bigger behind the ball, perhaps because of the black, the black head, the finish.
Great, and we always like to try and give, you know, some sort of indication as to the handicaps that each iron was designed for, because if you've got six different irons in the range, it's really hard to sort of pick which one might suit you. So just explain a little bit about blueprint. It's one piece forged, 8620.
Yeah, traditional loft 34. Like I said to you, you've got to be a serious ball striker, a low handicapper in my opinion, to use these. But yeah, great feeling golf club. You'll expect probably high spin numbers from them.
Absolutely. And we always give a forgiveness rating. So from 1 to 5, a blade is 1, a hybrid iron is 5. This is
definitely
the toughest one to be able
falls
to
into
use.
Category 1, this one.
Okay, i59. I've not put a price up here because we haven't been given a price yet, but essentially it's a hollow-bodied player's iron. We wouldn't have been saying that 5 years ago.
No, definitely not. Like I say, I'm intrigued as to the construction behind that, Simon. Why? Wonder why they've done it. I mean, we'll know shortly, but a lot of guys are going forged face and casting the body, and these have gone steel face, forged body, haven't they? So
yeah,
just a little bit different way of doing it, really. But coming back to this, I mean, the forgiveness rating of 2.
Yeah, it could be 2.5.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it's nudging up there, isn't it?
Handicap. Remember, this is only a guide, guys. Handicap 6 and below. But again, you've got to be a good ball striker to use these irons, in my opinion.
Okay, and we didn't cover it off earlier, but there's some pretty good shaft options there on the i59 as well.
Fantastic. All different weights, flexes there, right the way through the bag. So you're very, very strong. Your dynamic god there, 120x100s, through to your lightweight graphite shafts. So you can get all options there, different grip thicknesses as well, so you can really get them. With that mixed combination in lofts, like you said, Simon, you can really get it dialed in for your optimum numbers.
Okay, and just lastly on the i59, the aluminium core, it's a third of the weight of steel, so you're basically freeing up weight from the centre, which then means that you can put more weight in the toe and heel to make it more forgiving. i210, it's been around since 2018. Yeah. It's a bit of a legendary.
Yeah, it feels like it's been around forever, but that's probably the reason behind that. Like you say, but number one iron played on tour for Ping. Just a really nice traditional looking golf club. Again, it sits nice. I actually use these myself. They don't look too small behind the golf ball. They're not a huge footprint. Quite a small top line.
Yeah.
Good feeling as well, even though they aren't forged. So we're going to go forgiveness rating 2.5, handicap range 10 and below. Like I say, you don't have to be a fantastic ball striker to use these.
Okay, and now we've moved over from forged into cast heads as well.
Yeah.
Okay. And then i500, we know that this has been in the range for a number of years. It's highly likely that it might get replaced at some point in the near future. We don't have any news about that yet.
No. But again, we're into the hollow body design now, so we're going to get hopefully a little bit maximum ball speed. Loft a little bit stronger now, 30.5 on the 7-iron. Forgiveness rating 2.5-3. And handicap range 12 and below.
Okay.
And well, I say it's only a guide.
Only a guide.
Can't stress that enough.
Okay, G425, new for this year, just aimed at a wide
audience of players. Huge. Like we've done in whites, aimed at wide audience, because you're better ball strikers, because of the construction and the designs behind it, you're still going to get those optimum spin numbers. And the guys that aren't the consistent strike-wise, a little bit more spread all over the face, you're going to get consistent numbers in terms of not as much ball speed drop-off. You'll still maintain a little bit of spin. That's why it's been very, very popular.
Okay, and then last but not least, the G710.
Yeah, so like I say, maximum forgiveness rating now, Simon, into the 4, and handicap range, anything from beginner down to the 28 and below.
Okay, and anybody that's chasing real distance as
well. Yeah, that would be the way to go, definitely.
Okay, there's loads of information there. Let's move on and have a look at how all of these irons compare in data. The 6 irons in the Ping iron lineup. Which one actually suits me, Neil?
Yeah, that's the question, Sam. So let's start with, obviously, Blueprint. Mm-hmm. Now, again, you've got to be looking at the numbers there. They're pretty good. I'd like to consider, when I was testing all these, I was hitting it pretty really well.
Yes.
So swinging it good. I thought I could potentially use them at my sort of standard, but just the long iron thing would be the thing that the guys have got to consider. So if you're looking at a set of blueprints, just remember what you're putting on the line, sacrifice with a miss hit in a long iron, because the ball speed drop off will be quite high.
Okay, so stepping down to the i59, i210, this is where a lot of the Ping Tour Pros will be choosing between.
Definitely.
What are they going to be looking for? Because we've seen with you that the i59 is pretty high spin.
Yeah, so and is that down to the extra grooves, mate? That'd be interesting to see with some of the feedback from the guys watching when they do test them, if they do manage to get on the launch one, to see if it actually spins a little bit more for yourselves. We could see off the naked eye, couldn't we, that we thought it looked to be going quite high and spinning quite a bit.
Okay.
Now, I think that this is quite a tight category, because obviously with Ping saying that you're going to get the forgiveness of an i210 out of an i59, and it's a smaller looking head. If you could see beyond that, then that might be a good option to go to try the 59. But listen, this is not a broad category, Simon, the i59.
No, it's not a wide audience,
No,
it's very narrow.
No. Yeah. No, the wide audience, mate, would be more towards the G425, but we'll come to that in a second.
Just to pick up on that, you know, for me, on the i59, why would I choose it? Well, actually, yeah, if I like i210s, but I'd like it in a smaller chassis, then that's probably the reason why I would be picking i59s. It just shows you, you know, how far the iron category's come, you know, that you've now got a really good looking player's iron with a hollow body, and it's got more forgiveness, even though it's a smaller head.
And I dare say, if you were to play a little bit more on tighter, firmer ground conditions, with that narrower sole might help a little bit more over an i210, because they've got quite a wide sole, haven't they, the i210?
Yes, yeah, really good point. So i500, we know that people might struggle to actually get hold of a set of these at the moment. They've been in the range for a very long time. Highly likely they might get updated at some point in the near future. A lot of people would find themselves in the past choosing between that and the i210. I'm guessing at the moment, you know, that most people are probably going to hold off, you know, until there is a new iron available to compare that against the i210 possibly.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And then moving on, Simon, obviously your G425, fantastic iron, much more of a broader audience. I see great ball strikers that use these, because they still produce the numbers that they're looking for, the peak height, the spin, the descent angle. But you've got your forgiveness in there, so your higher handicap can use this as well.
Yeah, and I do think as well, you know, the G-irons in the past, they have been pretty big, chunky beasts. This is actually a model, you know, which is pretty well tailored down and squeezed into quite a small package.
It does suit a wide
range of audience. And then at the bottom, so the G710, you know, that's for your players that are really aiming at the distance market.
Definitely.
Really, really like the look, you know, the confidence the confidence inspiring, larger head. I really like how it's black. So it's almost like it sort of loses a little bit of its size because it's in a dark colour. Looks great sat behind the golf ball as well.
I think, again, in a long iron, it's going to be a little bit easier for the guys to launch as well. Combine that with one of the lighter weight shafts and you could be onto a win if you're looking to maximise some distance.
Okay, so we started this video about i59s because they are the new model in this particular video. How do they compare to the competition? Because it's quite a wide range of competition.
Yeah, well, you can see we've selected some of that we've tested in the past time and actually what we've put them up against a test. This isn't data that we've used on a previous day. We've done it all as one, guys. But you can see we've put it against the Mizuno, the JPX 921 Tour, the Strixon's LX7, the TaylorMade P790, the Callaway Apex
770.
Sorry, 770, my apologies. And the PXG 0311T, the Gen 4. Fantastic lineup there, and you can see. I mean, the data. If you're looking at it, high. The thing that strikes me straight away, the high spin numbers from the i59. So if you're somebody who maybe struggles to get those spin numbers up, and you look at a golf club in this category, it could be a great option. Personally, I generate quite high spin anyway, so I'm not too sure if it would be more for me. But it's definitely worth considering. So high spin and steep descent angle, definitely getting the thumbs up, and quite a high picard as well on the i59.
Okay, and just worthwhile, just picking up on this, you know, we have mixed up the irons here. So you've got some that are hollow-bodied, others that are just a forged head. So you can see the difference between them. We haven't put these into any particular order. This is just the order that we tested in. So it just gives you a good indication of how each model compares against the i59. Right, there's loads of information there. If you like the video, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.